In this exercise, you're going to use the cables and the rope, and we're going to do cable crunches. Now, you're going to select a moderate weight. Now, I'm not a big fan of going heavy when it comes to adding loads for the abs. I'm more interested in the contraction, so that's what you always want to think about. I'm going to use the Bosu ball here. And, of course, you don't need to, but it's going to add a little bit of an additional core stability challenge, which is always a good thing. So you're going to pull in your abs. You're going to think about using your trunk and not your arms to do this move, okay? So you're going to stabilize through the shoulders, shoulders down, and you're going to exhale and come up. I want you to think about your midsection as a upside down U. So you want to keep that curve, so to speak, like you're rounding over a barrel, okay? And you want to maintain that drawing, okay? So when you're doing this, you can anchor and press your toes onto the floor, or once you get good at stabilizing, okay, you're gonna exhale, okay, and as you come down, okay, you can use one leg only to touch or intermittently touch as you need to, okay. Readjust, make sure you got the right spacing between the cable machine, okay. So at the bottom of the move, you want to forcefully exhale, okay, to get all the air out of your diaphragm and to increase that contraction. It's really important that you get your breathing to work with you, especially when you're doing abs. So exhale, and you want to simultaneously think about contracting and squeezing those abs with the exhalation. Okay, so now we're gonna change this up a little bit. I'm gonna lighten the load for this one, just a bit, okay? So I'm gonna hold on one hand, okay? I'm gonna push away a little bit here, I'm in the right position. So obviously this will work more of your intercostals, your obliques. I like to place my hand behind my back simply because that opens up my chest and prevents me from rounding forward. Okay, so you're gonna come down, and then you're gonna go across towards that opposite knee. Okay, exhale. You don't necessarily want to think knee, elbow to the knee. You want to think twist. Okay, twist with the midsection. So it's often the shoulder towards the opposite side. Okay, so. Exhale, round over, and keep that U shape as you come down, okay? Okay, and of course you want to overload and just keep it on that side. Keep it tight and full range, okay? But you don't want to come up completely. You want to keep tension on those working muscles. And remember, you're just holding on with the weight with your hand, you're not pulling with your hands or arms, you're just stabilizing, okay? So one more way to do this is I'm gonna pull back. I'm gonna shift my weight back, okay? And then I'm gonna repeat that. Exhale. Again, I'm thinking shoulder towards the opposite side, and of course you wanna switch off and be symmetrical always. I often advise starting with the weaker side. Keep your head in neutral position. Exhale. Once you get into the habit of forcefully exhaling with that contraction, you're going to feel it so much more. It's part of that mind-muscle connection. And of course, you can go to the doubles and hold right at the end of the range of motion and get some small micro repetitions, mini reps along with full reps, okay? Hold
isometric holds are always also effective, done after a set. And in that position, you do want to round out the back. I know I'm constantly hammering flat back, but for that position, that will help you create that U position when you round it over, okay? Add that one, and you can do that one in between some leg sets.